Hey, what's up, YouTube? Today is July 4th, 2011, and happy 4th of July. I kind of had a bad experience tonight that I just want to make a video about. So I went with a buddy of mine to a fireworks display tonight in my neighborhood. At one point in the evening, we left the group because my friend was going to go home, and I left my stuff in his car, and I decided I was going to stay for a bit longer, so I was walking with him back to his car, right? We got kind of lost on the way back. We decided to ask some people for directions that we saw coming up. You know, this white couple, a white woman, a white man, coming up on the sidewalk. And yeah, my friend was like, you know, let's ask them where the street is that we were looking for. So as I approached them, the woman, like, immediately, like, grabs hold of the dude's shoulder. Like, she's like, this woman's like terrified, like she, like her eyes got big, and I'm not even exaggerating, like she was really scared. And I started talking, and then as I was talking, there were fireworks in the distance, and, you know, sort of drowned out what I was saying. And my friend was like, no, you have to speak louder. So I spoke louder, and I was like, you know, can you tell us where such and such street is that we're looking for? The guy was like, I don't know. And it just kept walking, and the woman was like scared and like on his arm like the entire time. You know, they walked past, and I was like, what the heck was that? I could just see the terror in this woman's eyes. The woman was visibly scared. There was so much going through me in that moment. I was angry. I was hurt. That I instilled like fear in this woman. I was confused because I just wanted to ask for directions, and I felt I was already, there was a hostility that was assumed when I was approaching them, and just all this stuff was going through my head. And my friend who was with me, he's South Asian American, so he's also, you know, dark skinned, and he was like, you know, like, dude, what was that? And like, you know, we started joking about it. He's like, you know, you need to work on your boo and like scare them. And and I'm listening, and he's like, you know, trying to make light of the situation, and I just started, like, you know, crying or whatever, because I was just, like, really upset and mad, and he was totally, like, supportive and sympathetic, and, you know, sort of held me for a little bit, and, until I just got it all out, because in that moment, I was like, you know, I'm sick. I was just sick of it. I was just sick of, like, just my body just being a sight that inspires fear, and I can't really describe what it's like to feel like, you know, just the very sight of you instills fear in someone. I don't know, hatred, I guess, would be part of it too. But I can't really describe what that's like. It's just, it's a really awful feeling. I'm not a bad guy, and I hate being treated that like I am. And I don't want to ignore the gender piece when I'm talking about this either. I'm not suggesting that women don't have a valid fear of men approaching them at night. I totally get that. At the same time, the point I'm trying to make is that, you know, two middle-class, college-educated, clean-cut-looking white guys, and I say that because we were two college-educated, middle-class, clean-cut-looking men of color. But yeah, two white men with the same appearance would not instill the same level of fear in Ann Arbor, Michigan. For me, it's the intersectionality of both my race and my perceived gender that's causing all of these problems. And as we were walking back, you know, we eventually found his car and I got my stuff out. He's like, you know, I think we can get back to our friends, you know, should mention what happened. Like, now mind you, like, the group of people we were with, they were all white. And I was like, you know, I don't think they're gonna care much. I don't know. He's like, well, why don't you think they care? And I was like, well, why should they? I mean, it doesn't affect them. You know, you're brown, you understand. He's like, yeah, but I'm not brown in the same way that you are. He's like, well, you know, they'll, you know, just tell them so they know that's why you're feeling how you're feeling, because I was still really upset about what happened. So I get back to the group, you know, I'm just still thinking about what happened. I was just still really angry and hurt and just, like, frustrated and everything. You know, I mentioned it to a couple of folks who were just, you know, sitting, and immediately they were kind of like, oh man, that sucks. But they were also like, I wonder if that woman was still shaken from the fireworks, or I wonder if that woman was on psychedelic drugs, or they kept making these lighthearted excuses for what happened, these other explanations. This, I mean, this gets at the point of this video right now, which is, you know, the discomfort that I feel and I think other white people feel when race is part of the discussion. I sort of anticipated before I even brought this up, what's the point in talking about race with these people? Either they're not going to care, but also I was like, it's not going to go anywhere, you know, even if they did care. And no one seemed really interested in talking about racism. One of the guys there that did live in the neighborhood mentioned that, you know, he had some neighbors he didn't like in the area, but he didn't think, you know, he wasn't sure if they were racist or not. And I was like, you know, people who act this way towards black folks, I'm willing to bet, wouldn't even think of themselves as racist. Because that's how ingrained, I think, this fear of black men or black people in general, I think that's how much is ingrained in our thinking that we won't even see it. I think that's how invisible the issue of race is in this picture. Feeling that I can't talk about something that's real to me without it getting either shut down or made into a trivial matter or a joke. Stressful and upsetting. Even though a part of me feels I'm not being overly sensitive or overreacting, part of me, it makes me question whether I am. The fact that white folks are just so not wanting to engage the issue of race in instances such as this makes me feel like, you know, maybe this isn't a big deal. And it has a silencing effect. You know, I didn't want to initially bring this up around them because I sort of anticipated it wouldn't go anywhere. And then this happened and just sort of confirmed, like, why did I even bring this up? Why did I create a moment that was uncomfortable for me and probably uncomfortable for them? Perhaps the most upsetting is that I can go through something like that, that brings me so much pain, and I can't share it with them. And I feel the need to keep it to myself to prevent myself and them from feeling uncomfortable about it. I remember when I first started transitioning, maybe 6 months into my transition, my godmother and I were talking, and I mentioned some of the stuff that I was experiencing. And I remember she said to me, she's like, yeah, I've always wondered, does that stuff really happen? I mean, I sometimes wonder if black men are exaggerating. And this is like a black woman saying this stuff to me. And I was like, no, black trans men, I think, are in a unique position in which we can really say whether or not this sort of racism exists, because we have something to compare it to. Black biological men have nothing to compare it to, because, you know, this is something that they've been experiencing their whole lives, right? Black trans men, we do have something else to compare it to, and that's just living as a black female and being perceived as female. And I said to her, you know, well, as someone who spent the first 20 so years as a black woman or a black female, I think that I'm not making this up. I don't think I am being overly sensitive. I notice a definite difference in how I'm treated since transitioning. There really is no motive for a black person to make this sort of stuff up. There is a motive, or I guess an ultimate purpose being served in white people not acknowledging racism. Because if you ignore the fact that people of color are still feared and hated in this country and other countries, then you allow for certain systems of power to remain intact. Well, anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about tonight. So anyway, I'll catch y'all later. Peace.